Morning students, I welcome you all in online classes of Bhuvnesh Bal Vidyalaya and I am your English teacher Deval Rajawat. Today I am going to explain direct and indirect speech. The speaker's word can be reporting in two ways, that is direct speech and indirect speech. When the sentence expresses the exact words of the speaker, then the sentence is in direct speech. Like the example, the teacher said to Rajesh, "You have a bright future." In this sentence, the teacher is a speaker and teacher said to Rajesh that you have a bright future. You have a bright future is the exact word of the speaker, teacher. That's why this sentence is in direct speech. Now coming to indirect speech. What the speaker has said without using the exact word, then the sentence is in indirect speech. See the example, the teacher told Rajesh that he had a bright future. In this sentence, teacher is the speaker and the teacher told to Rajesh indirectly without using the exact word. So that's why this sentence is in indirect speech. Yes, there are some changes in direct into indirect speech also. If we have to change direct speech into indirect speech, there are some rules. So first rule is that if the reporting verb of the direct speech is in present or future tense. Now your question is coming in your mind that what is reporting verb? After the subject in the verb, there is a verb which is reporting verb. See the example, my friends say. In this example, say is a reporting verb. Okay students, so if the reporting verb is in present or future tense, then the verb within the inverted commas will remain same. There is no change in tense. See example, my friends say he is very handsome. In this example, say is a reporting verb and it is in present tense. So if we have to change this sentence into indirect speech, there will be no changes in the tense within the inverted comma. So sentence will be like this. My friends say that he is very handsome. See another example. My granny will say you need to eat well. In this example, will say is a reporting verb and it is in future tense. So if we have to change this sentence into indirect speech, there will be no change in the verb within the inverted comma. So sentence will be like this. My granny will say that you need to eat well. Now coming to the another rule of changing direct speech into indirect speech. If the reporting verb is in past tense, listen to me very carefully students. If the reporting verb is in past tense, then the verb within the inverted comma will undergo different changes in the indirect speech. The first changes will be like this. If the verb is in simple present tense, then it changes into simple past tense. See the example here. The girl said the flower is pretty. Now this reporting verb is in past tense. So if we have to change this direct speech into indirect speech, the tenses in the inverted commas will also change. Okay, so a sentence will be like this. The girl said that the flower is changes into was in simple past tense. The flower was pretty. The girl said that the flower was pretty. Now coming to the next rule. If the verb is in present continuous tense, so we have to change that verb in past continuous tense. See the example. The old man said the rain is falling very heavily. Here is falling is in present continuous tense. Okay. Now we have to change it. So the old man said that the rain is falling changes into was falling. So kya ho jayega? The old man said that the rain was falling very heavily. Now coming to the next rule, which is if the verb is in present perfect tense, then it will change into past perfect tense. Like example, the principal said all the students have passed. Here have passed is in present perfect tense. Okay, so now we have to change it. So the principal said that all the students had passed. Had passed is in past perfect tense. So a sentence will be like this. The principal said that all the students had past. Now, if the verb is in simple past tense, if it is in simple past tense, then it will change into past perfect tense. See example, Rohan said Sheetal arrived yesterday. Here the verb arrived is in past form. So if we have to change this sentence into indirect speech, we have to change this form also. So the past form changes into past perfect form. So sentence will be like this. Rohan said that Sheetal had arrived the previous day. Yesterday changes into previous day. Models also change into their past form, like may changes into might, can changes into could, shall changes into should, will changes into would. Okay, now coming to the pronouns. Pronouns will also change. First person pronoun and second person pronoun changes into third person pronoun. Now coming to the change in adverbs of time and place. The adverb of time and place will also change in indirect speech, like this changes into that, today changes into that day, these changes into those, now changes into then, here changes into there, tomorrow changes into the following day or the next day, yesterday changes into the previous day or the day before, and tonight changes into that night. Like the example, he said, I shall discuss this matter next week. Now, if we have to change this sentence, so first we have to change the verb and the adverbs. So he said that, comma and inverted comma changes into conjunction that. He said that I changes into third person pronoun he, shall changes into would, he would discuss, this changes into that matter, the next week changes into the following week. So sentence will be like this. He said that he would discuss that matter the following week. See the another example. She said we shifted to this house here, house 2 weeks before, 2 weeks ago. Now we have to change this sentence into indirect speech. First of all, we have to replace comma and inverted comma into that. In assertive sentences, students, comma and inverted comma replaced into that conjunction. So she said that we changes into third person pronoun they. Shifted is the verb which is in simple past form. So if we have to change it, first we have to change simple past into past perfect form. So they shifted into had shifted, to this changes into that house 2 weeks ago changes into before. So sentence will be like this. She said that they had shifted to that house 2 weeks before. Now coming to interrogative sentences. So what is an interrogative sentence, students? The sentences which ask something, which starts with WH word or question words, who, where, and what, these are interrogative sentences. And interrogative sentences ends with question mark. Now, if we have to change interrogative sentence into indirect speech, so there are some rules for it. In direct sentence, in direct speech, if the question starts with yes or no, so if we have to change it, then the reporting verb will be changed into asked or inquired, and comma and inverted comma replaced into if and whether. Like the example, she said, are you writing a poem? Now this sentence starts with helping verb are, and the answer of this question will be in yes or no, right? So if we have to change this sentence into indirect speech, what we will do first? First, we have to change the reporting verb. So said changes into asked, and comma and inverted comma changes into whether. So she asked me whether, you changes into first person pronoun I. I was writing a poem. See another example. I said to him, do you know when she will go home? Again, it's a question and it starts with helping verb and its answer will be in yes or no, right? So if we have to change it, so first we have to change the reporting verb. So said changes into asked. I asked him, comma and inverted comma replaced into if. He, you changes into he. He knew when she will changes into would go home. So sentence will be like this. I asked him if he knew when she would go home. In case of question word like who, how, where, etc. So if we have to change these questions, those starting with WH words, so there is no need to change the, there is no need to use if and whether. We have to use that question word in as a connector. Like see the example, where do you live? She asked me. So if we have to change it, she asked me where I lived. Listen students, if we have to change the interrogative sentence into indirect speech, the first rule is that the interrogative sentence changes into assertive sentence. Okay, so here also this interrogative sentence changes into assertive sentence. So sentence, she asked me where I live. See the another example, he asked how do you write poems. If we have to change this, again first of all we have to change interrogative sentence into assertive sentence, then other rules are applicable, right? He asked me how I wrote poem. So these are interrogative sentences. Now coming to imperative sentences, sentences which request something, sentences which gives an advice, which gives an order, those sentences are imperative sentences and it ends with full stop, right? If we have to change imperative sentences, the reporting verb is changed into asked, advised and requested. Okay, the rules of tenses will remain the same. Okay, and in place of comma and inverted comma we used to add to. Okay, see the example, I said take your seat. In this example, take your seat, it's an order, right? It's an order. So if we have to change it, what we will write? I asked him to, comma and inverted comma changes into to take his, your changes into his seat. I asked him to take his seat. Like this we have to change imperative sentences. Now okay, students, now coming to exclamatory sentences. Sentences which expresses a feeling, those sentences are exclamatory sentences and it's and these sentences ends with exclamation mark. Now if we have to change direct speech into indirect speech, so there are some changes in reporting verb also in exclamatory sentences, like the reporting verb is changed into exclaimed with joy, exclaimed with sorrow, exclaimed with anger, exclaimed with surprise, etc. And in place of comma and inverted comma that is used. See the example, he said how beautiful a place. Now this sentence is an exclamatory sentence, this sentence is an exclamatory sentence and we have to change it, right? So first of all we have to change the reporting verb. So reporting verb changes into exclaimed with joy. He exclaimed with joy that it was a very beautiful place. This is how we will change exclamatory sentences into indirect speech. Students, I hope you all understand. I hope you all like this video.